Let's start at its lowest setting.
Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Ed Lester, this is Showtime SBL.
And I'm Rich Tornetta, and I'm from Technically Fun.
Now, we're two guys that have a little bit of expertise in the world of electronics. Mm-hmm. So we want to use our understanding to show you some. We're in a car right now. Uses DC. I have an alternator, 320 amp alternator. Changes AC to DC to use on our cars. Well, AC, DC, voltage, current, what does that mean?
Electricity is really hard to visualize. I think that's the hardest part for most people, especially me. I'm a visual kind of person, and it's one of those senses that we just can't use to see electricity. I'm thinking if we went into our lab and we built some props, ways to visualize electricity and how it works, how it flows, that might give the viewers and me a better understanding of how it works.
Yeah, we can't see it directly, So why not have a prop or stand-in to show how it does work, give you some visual reference, right? Mm-hmm.
Let's go build some analogs.
Welcome once again to the Tech Fun Laboratory. Let's take a look at the equipment we're going to use today.
Okay, so now we have a car audio amplifier. It is a 12-volt DC car audio amplifier, and it's normally powered by a car battery. That is a 12-volt DC car battery, and it's usually hooked up to an alternator in your car that is powered by the engine. Now, we don't have an engine, and we don't have an alternator, but what we do have is an AC to DC converter. It's taking AC out of the wall and converting it to 12 volt DC, charging the battery, and it's also powering our amplifier.
The purpose of an amplifier is to amplify an audio signal. Our automotive amplifier takes 12 volt DC to power it and has to change the levels and form and control the current to output an AC waveform for the speakers.
Yes, but exactly what is voltage and what is current?
Let's go take a look.
Okay, buckets.
Buckets? Yeah, we're gonna use the reservoir of science to explain electricity.
That's not electricity.
Actually, we can use the reservoir as a stand-in for a battery and explain voltage and current flow from that battery.
Oh, I get it. So the voltage, right, is like the water, and the rate at which that water flows is the current.
Exactly! So we can look at this like it's a 9-volt battery. The amount of water in the reservoir is the amount of energy stored in that battery. And the pressure that it puts on the valve is the voltage.
Exactly. Now with this valve, if we were to just press it a little bit, that's like hooking up a small LED to that 9-volt battery. At this rate, the current flow is very small, and it would take a while to drain all the energy out of that battery. But if we were to empty it all at once,
all that current flow.
That's like hooking up a big motor to that little 9-volt battery. The current flow is really big and it would drain that battery all at once, and now the battery's dead.
So I think it was a pretty good way to understand how batteries and water kind of are analogs for each other. We tried as hard as we could to think of a different way to show you, but we got to admit other people have done water as a stand-in for showing voltage and current, and I got to admit that was a pretty good way. So if it's not broken, don't fix it. That's what we had to do as well.
Yeah, worked for me.
Yeah.
Now AC and DC. The directionality of electricity.
Oh, right.
Is there a good way to show that?
Electron flow and that kind of
thing? Yeah. So we'll build another prop to show kind of the different electron flow, different direction, different way they move, right?
Okay.
So let's go to the lab.
Back to the lab.
So behind me, we've built a rig to visualize the directionality of alternating current versus direct current.
Over here, we have the power source. In DC, which is direct current, that will be the battery. And current flows in one direction from that source to the load, which may be an LED or a motor. Now, AC is a little bit different. It's alternating current.
and it's alternating the direction. So it will go from the power source, which is the wall outlet or an audio amplifier, in a direction to the load and then back again. And the rate at which that direction changes is the frequency. So wall outlet will go 60 times a second, it's 60 hertz. So it'll change that direction 60 times a second. An audio amplifier, we can vary that according to the music. It's really cool.
So, Rich, as far as directionality, a way to see it, you think that was the best way?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we had some raw materials in the shop. We just built with what we could. But I think as far as visualization, it helped me understand how things like move in one direction and back and forth, that kind of thing. Yeah.
You had a great idea. He came up with the way putting the rope there. It really worked for me. So anyway, as far as DC, things work off of DC, will they work off AC? Things off AC, will they work off of DC?
Right, right.
You know, it's all electricity.
Yeah.
What about power levels? Things that are meant to work within a certain range. Take it above that range.
I think he just wants to blow things up.
You want to see things blown up.
It does sound fun.
Let's go.
Now we've already established that AC current comes out of that amplifier. And the frequency at which it comes out is generated by the tone.
Hey, Rich. Got an idea.
What?
It's a light bulb.
Yes, it is.
AC. What if the amplifier can power the light bulb?
Let's see.
It may tingle a little.
Wow! Look at that! So that's an incandescent bulb, 75 watts, being powered by an amplifier. And the frequency is dipping between about 60 hertz and 5 hertz, so that's why it gets a little low and flickery when it gets below about 10 hertz there. We're used to 120 volts coming out of the wall, AC, at 60 hertz. So that's working. So if that's an incandescent bulb, I wonder if an LED would work. This is an LED light bulb that I have. Look at that!
Much brighter, more efficient.
Much more efficient, yeah. And you see it's getting that flickery again.
Now these are cool AC appliances, but they're just light bulbs. How about a real AC appliance like the hairdryer?
That's not gonna work. How would a hairdryer be powered by an amplifier?
You can dry your hair with an amplifier. Oh, that's great. Now the thing though is, these are AC appliances meant for the wall outlet, and we're powering them from an audio amplifier. What about the reverse?
What if we were to hook up a speaker to a wall outlet?
Yeah, exactly.
So that's 60 hertz coming out of the wall. It's 120 volts, so it would be a lot, but it might blow it, but I still think it'd be kind of fun.
Let's play with it.
Okay.
Now, we only have two of these woofers, so before we plug it into the wall, we want to plug it into higher voltage DC. So we have batteries here to supply 24 volts DC. Now, it's only one direction, but it's a lot higher voltage than what we did before, so let's see what happens.
So you've seen the power of direct current on a subwoofer. Now we're going to plug it into the wall. Here's a power strip. This is 120 volts coming directly out of the wall at 60 hertz directly to the subwoofer. Now, we hooked it up to a dimmer so that we can vary the amount of voltage going into it. We don't know what's going to happen, and that's kind of the fun part about experimentation. So let's turn the power strip on. And let's start at its lowest setting. All right, I'm gonna back up a little bit. Okay, so no dimmer this time. We're just gonna hook straight power to this 4-inch mid-range. I'm gonna step back. Good thing we have our safety goggles.
So obviously that was a little bit too much power to our little mid, so we have another mid, a bigger mid. should handle a little more power. To be on the safe side, we're going back to our 500 watt amp so we can vary the power a little bit. The wire in the voice coil is still small, but it shouldn't open as quickly. It should be pretty cool.
God, I love blowing things up.
I love the smoke coming out the sides. Oh, did it.
Why is destruction so much fun?
I don't know. It just is.
It just is. Yeah, I'm sorry. I love it. I'm sorry.
I want to do more. I had such a fun time.
Yeah,
you know,
we both did. Yep.
Very interesting things that we cover. At least we're interested in it. Keep the feedback coming, guys.
Please, yeah.
Love all that stuff, right? Let's give another t-shirt every episode, right? Rafael Fernandez. Ralph's Hummer. Always commenting and everything, especially
thanks,
on
buddy.
Facebook and Instagram. I'm on there. So you're getting the Excess Power t-shirt this time.
Very good stuff.
Love you guys. So thank you for joining. Check out Rich's channel, too.
Technically Fun. You guys have been great. We have a personal goal I've set of 500 subscribers. I'd love to get you guys subscribing to my channel. And you've already been sharing and liking the videos. So that's amazing. Thank you very much.
He's putting up some great videos. We got more coming. Couple more episodes,
oh, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Hopefully more after that.
Hopefully more. Yeah, we're slated for about 6 right now. This is what, episode 4?
Yeah.
So yeah, hopefully a couple more, but hopefully more after that. We're gonna see if we can take this thing a little further.
Yeah, keep the comments coming in. We're adjusting things based off of your feedback. If you like something, don't like something, right? So keep on commenting, keep on sharing.
Yep.
Love you guys.
Yep.
Stay tuned next time. And remember, if it sounds fun,
it probably is.
That's pretty cool.